Hey guys, it's Penny the Accountability Queen coming at you today with my blend of the month. It is February and we are in the month of not only the Love Day, Valentine's Day, so you can make this for your sweetie, but we are also in the National Heart Health Month. Now, the National Heart Association has their month every February where they promote their campaign Go Red, and that is to build awareness to the fact that, unfortunately, heart disease is still the number one killer of women. It claims the lives of 1 in 3 women. There's a lot of factors that go into that, one being lifestyle, another is the stress that we all deal with on a daily basis, and just the lack of exercise and taking care of ourselves. And unfortunately, it is still the number one killer. And I wanna just bring this to you. It's a very good blend for cardiovascular health, but yet it still tastes amazing. It tastes like a dessert. So if you're craving some chocolate, and you're craving something just a little bit on the sweet side, this is still super healthy for you, but will give you that little bit of edge just to satisfy the sweet tooth or the chocolate craving. And this is gonna be called my February Chocolate Covered Cherries Blend, okay? So it's really good, super simple to make, and I plan on presenting a new blend every month, and this is the blend of the month for February, so you can make it for your sweetie for Valentine's Day, or you could make it for you and your sweetie. You could double the recipe and split it between you, or you could give it to your kids if you have a couple of kids you want to just, you know, give them something sweet but something healthy at the same time. And it is low in sugar overall. So when I'm saying sweet, it just naturally has some sweetness to it, but it has a ton of healthy benefits. So without further ado, let's get started. We have a blender top, obviously, and I've got my cup of greens. Now, my greens this time are spinach. So I have a cup of fresh spinach. Now, if you don't think that you can handle greens in your blends and you want to get going on blending the way that I blend, I would suggest freezing any greens you buy. So this is about a large handful, or a decent handful. I wouldn't say it's super large. It's just a handful of greens that basically makes up a cup. You can do as many as you want. So as you adjust, because I can't even taste the greens in this blend at all. This one cup of greens does not come out in this blend. The chocolate and cherry comes out immensely, but the greens do not. So I have my cup of greens. You can do more, you could do less, but I would highly recommend doing more. The fiber content and iron content and nutrients in spinach is awesome. You can use any greens you like. The milder ones are spinach and like something like Swiss chard. Those are the more mild flavored greens that you can put in blends if you're just starting out and you're kind of uncertain on putting greens in your blends and you think it's kind of weird. You know, you've been doing smoothies maybe with fruit for years. Well, this is a way for you to get going on, you know, getting some greens in your diet. If you freeze any of the greens you buy, honestly, it kind of takes the flavor out. So it preserves the nutrients and it takes the flavor out. Just make sure they're not wet when you put them in. If you're gonna rinse them beforehand, let them dry out really well before you put them in a plastic bag to put them in the freezer and freeze for using in your blends. So that's just my tip on adding greens to your blends without having the flavor, so that you can start getting the potassium and nutrients that you need and fiber from full blends instead of just using greens powders. I'm not saying those greens powders aren't great out there, but I get a lot of questions on, can't I just use green powders and not worry about putting greens in my blends? Yes, you can, but I wouldn't recommend it all the time. I would really recommend this being the mainstay and then using that when you just don't have any fresh greens or you don't have any in stock in your freezer. Okay, so getting on with it. These are dark sweet cherries, but dark red cherries too. Anyway, these are so awesome. You could also use strawberries in this recipe, and it would be a chocolate covered strawberries recipe. But the cherries to me just give it a little bit different flavor because I don't use cherries all the time. And I use a half a cup. Now, a half a cup of cherries is equivalent to about 9 grams of sugar. Okay, so it's not too high in sugar. This is 18 grams of sugar for a whole cup. So if you were to split it with someone and do a whole cup in your blend, you might taste the cherries a little bit more doing it that way. So it might be beneficial to kind of put a whole cup and double up your other ingredients, and you'll kind of taste those cherries a little bit more, and then you could split it with someone. You'd still get that 9 grams of sugar. So it's not like really high in sugar. It's natural sugar. You're getting fiber from this as well. You're getting 3 grams of fiber for a whole cup. So 1.5 grams for a half a cup, and that's only like 40 calories, 45 calories in fruit, honestly, for a half a cup is really low. So that's an awesome way to get a little bit more fiber. You got the greens that has the fiber. And then this time, instead of just water, I'm using half unsweetened almond milk and half water. Now you could use all almond milk unsweetened. A whole cup is only 40 calories, so it's not like it's really high. I just am not big on using a lot of milks in my drinks, but this one makes it more smooth, so I'm using half and half, so it's a whole cup of liquid. Whether you want to use coconut milk, rice milk, if you just want to use water, it's just a whole cup of fluid. And then I'm using 1 cup of ice. So I've got 1 cup of ice. Okay, so 1 cup of ice. And then I'm gonna meet you at my blending station and show you the rest of the ingredients. Okay guys, so here we are at the blending station. Now if you have not seen my video on my blending station tour and what we keep, all of the ingredients, the superfood ingredients and all of that, you'll want to check that out. I'll post a link below in the description, because I did a whole tour and 3 different videos on my blending station, what we keep in stock and our typical blends. You might want to check that out because there's just a lot of great information in those. But today we're going to be making it, like I said, chocolate covered cherry blend. So we're going to be doing a serving of chocolate plant-based protein powder. So that's 2 scoops for a serving. That's about 20 grams of protein. So this is a nice protein blend, okay, and then it's plant-based protein, and I have cacao powder, okay? So I have cacao powder we're going to be adding in for an additional chocolate burst, along with it being a superfood that is ultra antioxidant filled, and cacao nibs. Now, the chocolate powder, if you don't already have this or haven't already tried this, we're gonna put 1/2 tablespoon in. That's that extra chocolatey chocolate flavor, okay? The cacao powder, before I move on, is nature's dark chocolate, okay? This is where all chocolate originates. This is the raw chocolate. They take the fats out and then they grind it down into a powder, but that's all the process that happens here. This is an ultra super food. It basically lifts your mood, and it is amazing for cardiovascular health. Amazing for cardiovascular health. This has flavonoids that are your antioxidants, over-the-top antioxidants. It's high in magnesium. It has high potassium. It's got some iron, some vitamin, some calcium, and it is really low in calories and has no sugar, yet it has high fiber. So here we are again with a cardiovascular healthy food, superfood, that we're putting in our blend. We already have our superfood protein, plant-based protein powder. We've got our cherries, which are super good for your heart and your body and antioxidant filled. And then we're going to be using another thing, which is the chia seed. And that we're going to be using, again, 1/2 tablespoon, okay? 1/2 tablespoon of that. That is amazing omega-3 fatty acids. It has fiber, it has antioxidants, and it is an omega-3 fatty acid, so it's super good for your heart health once again. And then we've got the cacao nibs. Now these nibs, what's great about this is they're dark chocolate nibs, so they really don't have any sweetness at all to them, okay? I've not put them in a container out here because I just got these. I don't always keep them around, but I wanted to have them for this blend. They're a little on the pricey side, but they last you a really long time, and I typically throw this in the fridge. So this has protein. It's the basically little nibs of this. This is ground down into the powder, and this itself is the just more of the raw little pieces of chocolate. Now it's a bitter chocolate because it's dark chocolate, but the great thing about this is they do have a sweet one. It's a little more pricey, you get less in the bag. And it just has a little bit of sugar. This has absolutely no sugar and is super high in fiber. Again, it's 9 grams of fiber for 3 tablespoons. Not that we're gonna be using that much. But this has got good fats, it's got protein, again, it has magnesium, the potassium. So again, one more thing, and what's great about these is when you put them in a shake and you do it just right, they are like, you get these little bits throughout the shake of chocolate. So although they're not sweet, the cherries and the protein powder make the shake have a little bit of bright sweetness, and the cacao nibs and chocolate just make it decadent. So what I'm gonna add in here is 1/2 tablespoon of the cacao nibs, but I'm gonna wait until this is halfway blended so that that way the cacao nibs don't get completely pulverized and they stay nice and in little bits and pieces, and it'll be amazing. It tastes great. All right, I'm gonna get this blended up and I'll show you what I mean. There you have it, my healthy chocolate-covered cherries blend for February, the blend of the month. Share it with someone you love, your sweetheart, your best friend, your sister, your kids, and teach everyone about the importance of heart health. Taking care of your heart from the inside out, getting your exercise, eating clean foods, and lowering your stress levels, controlling stress, finding ways to manage your stress. That is so key and imperative in this day and age. So I encourage you, share this video with someone you love and you want to encourage to take better care of themselves. And if you haven't already done so, be sure to subscribe. I will have a new featured blend every month and probably some in between as well. But I will for sure have a new featured blend every month. I've just gotten started with my channel. I have plenty to share with you guys when it comes to taking care of you. All right, again, I'm Penny the Accountability Queen, and I help you remain accountable to your goals. Until next time, bye-bye.
Oh, that's good.
Oh, yeah.